Now, throughout my years of uni and high school, math has always been one of my strongest subjects. However, whenever I get a good grade on a math test, people are like, "Oh my god, it must be because you're Asian." That's not true. Mostly, it's because growing up, I taught myself to understand math. And today, I'm going to share with you some of my tips so you can understand math as well and get A pluses on every exam. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and today we are going to talk about math and how to study it. Math is everyone's favorite subject.
I lied.
And likewise with math, time is of the essence, so I'm going to get straight into the first tip. So with math, memorizing is one thing, but understanding is the next level of things. Because 2 times 2 equals 4, but do you understand why it equals 4, or do you just remember from that childhood times table chart that every kid had in the back of their bathroom door for some reason, or every primary school had it as well? Same with algebra. Like, if you remember that x equals 2 for one of the questions, that doesn't necessarily mean that you understand every algebraic question, because in every algebraic expression, x isn't always going to equal 2, and the variable isn't always going to be x either. It could be a, it could be b, it could be c, x, y, z, blah, 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 blah. Now, this is why you might not understand what's going on, because often with math, one concept, that base foundation, links to everything else that you will be taught in that topic. Because without a foundation, you can't excel and you can't build on top of it. It's like a building. If you don't have that foundation, it just topples down and it explodes, because you're not going to be able to answer the question. Now, in algebraic terms, if you don't understand the basic algebraic expression, like let's say 10 equals 2x plus 5, how are you going to get the answer for that if you don't understand the fact that you need to get x by itself? And when you move on to harder topics in algebra, such as simultaneous equations where you have two or more variables that you don't know, or if you move on to quadratics where you need to understand the quadratic formula and also the idea of like factorization and stuff like that, you're not going to be able to do it because you don't understand that base concept of getting an unknown variable by itself so you can find the answer. So your best bet with maths is to truly understand the basics. Like, even if it means that you're a little bit behind your class, understanding the basics will set you up to at least get a few marks. Even if you don't learn the rest of the content, so long as you have that foundation, you're bound to get a few more marks. And even if it means you might have to put a bit of extra hours into studying or a bit more effort into studying, you'll still be able to excel so long as you learn the foundation. And the best way to understand the basics is if you have equations and stuff like that, write them down, put them at the front of your bound reference, and then you can do some questions. So the best place to find questions is in your textbook, if you have one. And go to the chapter that concerns you and do the first few questions, because usually the first few questions of a textbook chapter is the foundation, the basics, basically getting you comfortable with that topic that you're learning. And then you can move on to the harder questions. Okay, now picture this. You're in a test or exam room and you're going through the questions. You've smashed out most of the questions, you're halfway through the exam, and it's been really easy so far. It's smooth sailing because you understand the foundation. And then, boom, you're hit with a hard algebraic question, a simultaneous equation. But you don't know how to do this because you've only spent your time studying how to do single equations where you just have to find one variable. So what should you do now? What do you do? You're stressing out, you're about to start crying. What should you do? You need to break everything down. I'm sure you've heard this a lot, but breaking it down is the be all or end all of this question. And you're looking at it, I'm like, how the hell am I supposed to find two variables? And why am I given two equations?
Oh, stress. Oh my God, stress. Oh my God!
Well, think about it. you go to your base algebraic knowledge. You need to understand what you're being asked first. You're asked to find X and Y. Well, if I use my algebraic knowledge, I can probably still try to get X by itself. Like, what can I do with this? Well, maybe I can put it into the second equation. Oh, look at that. There's no more X variables now in the second equation. It's just Y. So maybe I can get Y by itself now. And then after you find Y, you can put it back into equation one and you're like, hey, I can find X. Wow, so amazing. And yeah, like even if you don't do all of this, you're still bound to get one or two marks for that because you're still showing that foundational algebraic knowledge and you're still showing some sort of understanding of the fact that you should be getting an unknown variable by itself. Now, this rule of breaking things down and this rule of understanding fundamental concepts applies to all branches of math, calculus, geometry, etc. Like with calculus, for example, if you don't understand the basic laws of derivatives or antiderivatives, there's a very high chance that you're not going to be able to understand the rest of the calculus topics that you're doing, which is why it is so important to have that base ground for yourself. Even if you don't learn the rest of the subject, as I said earlier, you're still bound to get a few marks because of your base understanding of calculus. I wouldn't recommend that, but if you are really stretched on time and it's one day before your exam and you haven't studied one bit, just try to learn the basic laws and you should still be able to apply some of that knowledge to even harder questions as well. Now, as all the oldies say, practice makes perfect. With math and many problem-based subjects such as segments of chemistry and physics, practice, practice, practice. You will get good at the subject if you consistently practice. Expose yourself to that good old vitamin M. M is for math, if in case you didn't assume that already. Like, if you consistently practice math, the questions will become muscle memory for you. Even if there are different values, different numbers, and different things you have to find, you'll be able to find it because you understand all of that. Unfortunately, I just have to say it straight up, you need to do the questions, even if it's the challenging questions, you have to do them. I have said this in my How to Study Smart video, which should show up here or in the description, but to practice, I recommend you do the question first, look at the solutions. If you want to study efficiently, you don't want to spend too much time on one question because there are like an abundance of other questions. So if you can't understand it, do it with the help of the solutions and try to understand those solutions. You need to look at the solutions and understand it. Otherwise, it'll just get to the point where you're just memorizing questions again, and you don't want to do that. You want to understand the question, not memorize them. If you want more practice questions than what the course already provides you, approach your teacher or use Google, as I said earlier. There will be heaps of questions online because, as I said, math is a universal language that everyone understands. Now, if you should make sure that there is a good answer key under the questions, because you want to be able to see the solutions basically. And if there isn't an answer key and you still want to do the questions, you can approach your teacher to mark the questions whether or not you did it right. Now, I hope this video helped you guys in some way. Check out my socials and don't forget to like and subscribe and click the notification bell so you are notified every Friday when I release a video. And I'll see you in the next one. Okay, bye. She a devil, she a bad little, she a rebel, she put the foot to the pedal, it'll take a whole lot for me to settle.